I just saw actually that supposedly Monzo Bank have kind of let go a few people, and due to the whole lockdown, because I've not seen that much news again. Maybe I've not been paying attention because the tech startup world in London seems to move as quickly as it does in any other place, especially in Silicon Valley. So things are always changing. But I always have the impression that a lot of the startups or founders or whatever they may be in London are quite close. You know, they're quite close-lipped about what actually goes on. The journalists probably aren't as investigatory, whatever that term is, as it may be in the States. So some of the things that happen sometimes slip through the cracks, right? People can sometimes get away with murder in London more so than they may be able to do in the US. But news has kind of come out. This has been featured by TechCrunch, that Monzo's CEO and founder has decided to not take salary for the next 12 months in order to help the staff, help to keep, I guess, the majority of the staff on board, and obviously he's decided to enter a few of them into the voluntary furlough plan. So this is an article here from TechCrunch that sort of details it. It says Monzo CEO won't take salary for 12 months after a limited number of staff offered furlough. So I'm assuming, so let's read this, because a furlough usually should be applied to everyone, right? But let's see what's happening here. It says Monzo, the UK challenger bank with over 400 million subscriber account holders, sorry, is taking a number of precautionary steps to help see it through the current coronavirus downturn, including voluntary furloughs and its CEO foregoing a salary, TechCrunch understands. In an internal company-wide memo issued by the co-founder and CEO, Tom Bloomfield, he tells the bank's over 1,500 staff that he won't be taking a salary for the next 12 months. Jesus, that's a very honorable thing for him to do. And that the senior management team and the board have volunteered to take a 25% pay cut as salary, as have other Monzonauts within the company. In addition, a number of Monzo's UK employees are being offered voluntary furloughing for 2 months as part of the scheme rolled out by the UK government to protect jobs during the coronavirus lockdown, which is already impacting many companies, not just Monzo, including several other fintechs I know. Furlough ensures that employees still get paid even when work was decreased, and that when things have properly returned to normal, there's a job to come back to. Although well capitalized like other banks and fintechs, Monzo has seen customers' card spend reduced at home and, of course, abroad, meaning it has less seen less revenue from interchange fees. Sorry. So their model is entirely resting on the fact that they have a big user base and people are spending money, basically, which is interesting, isn't it? Because it's a challenger bank, but it still works the same way. Banks, I guess, your standard bank, what makes money what, on loans and credit and overdraft fees and all that sort of shit. So they work the same way, which is a bit of a frightening situation. It means that essentially they're going to need to compete with Lloyds, with Barclays, with NatWest, with Nationwide on the same level in order to kind of see any real returns, really, isn't it? That's what they're going to have to do. They're going to have to somehow get the lion's share of customers to jump on their platform, which is difficult because, you know, those banks are. Because I'm not too sure how confident people will be, you know, regular folk will be about, you know, dealing entirely with their banking or via their smartphone, not having any place to kind of walk into. Because I know that's why, you know, my mum will probably wouldn't mind switching to furlough, not furlough, sorry, switching to Monzo. But it's the idea that she couldn't necessarily go and talk to somebody in the physical location and have a meeting about something on an ISA or a loan or an overdraft would probably put a lot of people off, I'm assuming. It's definitely a millennial product, which probably makes leads me to believe that they're probably banking on the fact that a lot of the older clients that are, you know, still who still believe in the conventional banks are sort of going to phase out or, you know, die out, for lack of a better term. And once a new generation pick up steam, who are, you know, essentially, you know, they are smartphone native. You know, you give a 2-year-old an iPad these days and they know to do with it more than you do. So it probably makes sense that they're probably banking all their, you know, all their hopes on the next generation coming up and wanting to do all their banking online or via their smartphone. But yeah, interesting that. And it continues here, so therefore it makes sense to utilize the furlough scheme to help protect jobs in the future when the demand picks up again. This article looks like it's written by somebody that's very much a big fan of Monzo. By making it voluntary, it also means that staff with kids to homeschool or loved ones to take care of can use the option to hopefully make their lives easier for the time being. So Which is good, isn't it? Because I guess furloughing, obviously, for the companies is a bit of a sting, because I'm assuming they're going to have to front the cash before the cash comes in from the government. Because from what I understand, the government cash for furloughing is only going to get credited in the company's account in June. So they're going to have to cover the wages for the next couple of months, which probably makes sense because everyone will do that, right? That's probably your quote unquote severance package you'd get, especially after you've passed your probation and you've had a year. I think every year after, or every two, after 2 years of employment, I think it's a month or something. So you know that covers them for that much, but I guess the main benefit of the furlough is the fact that your job will still be open. It'll be similar to like going on a sabbatical, right? But your job is still there for you once you come back, which is great to see. So specifically, I understand Monzo is accepting up to 175 furlough applications with customer support, and up to what 220 applications from. So not everybody's going to get it. I'm assuming there's only a certain amount, because I'm sure they have more customer support agents than that. He says, meanwhile, at least one other UK challenger bank is using the government's furlough scheme. Starling has confirmed that he has put up to 41 people on furlough. In contrast, Revolut told TechCrunch no, he has no current plans to do so. As already mentioned, the scheme is available to UK companies right across the board, and several startups, including fintechs, have already applied for furloughing as a precautionary measure. Lastly, it should be stressed that none of the above should impact customers at Monzo, which is a digital bank, is pretty well positioned to operate during lockdown. Is this written by Monzo or is this written by TechCrunch? This is a bit bloody hell. It also has a fully licensed bank with customers' deposits up to £85,000, predicted as the UK government's deposits protection scheme. The comment by Ayn Bowden, founder of Sterling Bank, is below. But yeah, so yeah, Sterling Bank did a U-turn as well on that. But that's interesting to see, isn't it? One of the bigger, more I'd say well admired startups. I think if you talk to anyone that's worked in startups in London, the one place they all kind of dream to go, or they have a lot of great things to say, is Monzo, right? There's a lot of goodwill out there for them as a company. So for them to go through what they're going through is difficult. I'm assuming for us as customers of Monzo, it's also difficult to know that all this disruptions had been in the background. But you're hoping, because you'd imagine the banking sector will be able to survive somewhat. There could be robust because people are still going to need to move their money around, regardless of what's happening in the world right now. And maybe once everything gets back to normal, they'll be the first to get back on their feet. But yeah, thoughts and feelings go out to everybody at Monzo is affected by it. Hopefully those guys are protected and the furlough application goes through as may be, and they're able to come back into their roles once all the dust settles and all that stuff. But again, it's a great touch from the CEO and founder. You don't get a lot of these stories usually from startups. Usually the founders are proper wankers, so for someone like him to decide to forgo a year's worth of pay, right? He might have money anyway, but still, it's his, he's more than entitled to get a salary. And if he's, deciding to put it to one side for a year, which then allows the senior members of staff only to take a 25% cut, which is awesome too, right? They're only taking 25% hit on it as well. They're not having to do as drastic measures as him, which is great to see. He's definitely ascribing by the idea of like great leaders eat last, right? He's not doing the kind of the thing that what's his face, the guy at People.io, did to us and whilst we were there, where he kind of essentially scammed us all out of money and ran off into the sunset. But yeah, well done to him.